and look at all the options.
Not going to. Not going to. Thank you very much, Doc. I appreciate it. All right, I want to show this to the members of the press corps that might be watching right now. It's called a Pulitzer Prize. People like you at the New York Times could win one. I'll show you how. I want to tell you about a story that is coming out of Washington that you probably haven't heard anywhere. Byron York, he is the chief political correspondent for the Washington Examiner, is here to explain. Byron, can you tell me what happened on Thursday night in Washington?
It was a very strange event. There are officials called inspectors general at all of the federal agencies, and their job is to investigate allegations of stolen money, misspent money, fraud, other things like that. Because they do what they do, they often run afoul and irritate their bosses who are politically appointed. They sometimes irritate the White House. So because of all that, Congress gave them special job protections. There was a law passed last year that said if the president wants to fire an inspector general, he has to give Congress 30 days notice and he has to tell him why he's doing it.
Okay, hang on.
What happened last...
Wait. I just want to make sure I have that law. That's a new law?
Well, you know, it was passed in 2008, and one of its co-sponsors was, as a matter of fact, Senator Barack Obama.
Oh, wow. Okay, so wait a minute. What does it say again? 30 days notice, and you have to let Congress...
30 days notice
and
cause. He has to give Congress the reason why he is firing this inspector general.
Okay, well, that sounds like a good plan. You don't want anybody to intimidate the inspectors general. You want to be able to make sure that... Everything
you want to protect them from political retribution.
Sure.
So you've heard of the AmeriCorps program, which is the big national service program. Just got a huge tripling in a huge $5.7 billion bill a couple of months ago. There is an inspector general for the AmeriCorps program, and he got a phone call last Wednesday evening, and it was from the White House counsel's office. And the White House counsel's office told him that he had 1 hour to either resign or be fired. Now, he's an inspector general covered by all of these protections, and they told him you got 1 hour to resign or you're out.
Did he resign?
He did not. He refused. And what happened was the next day, Congress, the president did inform Congress of his intention to fire the inspector general, but he didn't give a reason. The president suggested there might be a reason. And what we know right now is that this inspector general did a rather controversial investigation of a friend and political supporter of the president, a man named Kevin Johnson, former NBA star who is now the mayor of Sacramento, California. And before he was mayor, Johnson had a nonprofit group for children called Saint Hope. And there were allegations that Johnson had misused thousands and thousands of dollars in federal AmeriCorps grants. And the inspector general, whose name is Gerald Walpin, investigated and found out that it was true, that Johnson had used this money to have AmeriCorps employees wash his car and run personal errands for him and do all sorts of stuff. So Johnson did an investigation, Gerald Walpin, the inspector general, did an investigation and confirmed all of these things. And his report made a number of people high up in the organization very unhappy.
Because Obama is a friend of Johnson, right?
He is indeed. Johnson is a supporter of the president, has made jokes about, you know, playing basketball with the president because Johnson was a big NBA star.
You know, I tell you, Byron, thank you. Great reporting in the Washington Examiner. And hang around because I actually want you to further this story for us tomorrow. I wish I had a chance to. Oh, my gosh. I do have a chance to talk to the guy who was terminated. Gerald Walpin is with us now. How are you, sir?
I am fine, thank you, and glad to be here.
Okay. I read this story. You were in your car. You get to the White House.
Yes.
Any idea that they were going to ask you to resign?
No, because I thought they were calling me, as the White House had called me about three or four times already that in the last 2 weeks, because I happened to be, you might disagree with this, a supporter of Sonia Sotomayor, even though I'm conservative.
Okay.
And they had asked me for help on that and to support her, and I was doing that. So I thought this was the same phone call.
Okay. And you are a conservative, but
yes.
You're not a, I mean, obviously you're endorsing Sotomayor, so you're an open-minded guy, and you have gone after Republicans in the past.
Oh, yes, I have.
Who have you gone after?
Well, I prosecuted Roy Cohn, for example. Mm-hmm. I was